Hi, I'm Sarah Lakomy. I'm an industrial designer. I'm also a master's student at Massey University and in the improvement and innovation team at the local hospital. So I have designed a product called Hatch, which is a bassinet designed to go in birthing facilities to facilitate in the acute postpartum period to enable maternal bonding. The whole idea with Hatch is that it enables that maternal proximity so that mums have the physical ability to be able to reach and manoeuvre and access necessary accessories to provide independent care for their newborn, so they're less dependent on calling a call bell and needing assistance from midwives. The real foundation of this project was around designing something with women, for women and by women, because traditionally women's healthcare has been sidelined. So I thought it was important to take a real equitable approach to this design and focus on an area that, you know, was due for some improvement, innovation and some excitement around it. Coming from an industrial design perspective, so a product designer, it's really important to understand that an object doesn't exist in isolation. It exists in a context, it exists because people are using it. It's really important to engage those people or understand the context that it's going to exist in before you get too deep into the design by basing it on assumptions. My first starting point was understanding the industry that I was going to be designing for and who the key stakeholders were in that field. So I worked collaboratively with a kaiāwhina, midwives, other midwifery support staff and mums through a range of different methods. So there were online surveys, some interviews, I went on a tour around a birthing facility, which gave me the opportunity to understand what the different priorities were for the different user groups and understand the context that my design would be going into. User-centred design is a really important part of having a human factors approach, particularly as an industrial designer. You can't design a product without having that end user involved from start to finish and having that back and forth conversation to really develop the product in a meaningful way, which is what made Hatch such a rewarding project.